Over the last year or so, I felt like I was becoming more busy than I was productive. I was still getting things done, it just wasn't really at the pace that I wanted it to be at. And I felt like I was spending more time than I should have organizing my work rather than actually doing it. A lot of people refer to this concept as busy work, which is basically the idea that you're getting things done, it's just not the most important stuff, you're just kind of filling time in your day. One of the things that can contribute to that problem is a workspace that isn't necessarily as organized and as streamlined as it should be. I feel like whenever people use different tools like Asana or Monday or Notion, they tend to fill it with all these different features and functionalities that they don't necessarily need, but it feels great to just have all that information on the screen. I came up with a term for these types of workspaces, and that is productivity porn. This is essentially the idea that if a feature or functionality is available within a productivity tool, it must be used, regardless of its necessity in helping you accomplish your goal. Put simply, you're prioritizing functionalities over the quality of your workspace. That's a huge problem because productivity tools and project management softwares are meant to help you actually get things done, not feel like you're getting things done when you're not. So because of that, I ended up completely rebuilding my Notion workspace that I use every single day. So if you've also been feeling like you spent a lot of time on busy work and not actual productive work, then here it is. And as always, if you want to download the template for yourself, it's the first link in the description. So let's go ahead and take a look. So the first thing that you see when you get here is the navigation as well as the quick actions. I'll go ahead and dive into all these different sections in a minute, but you do have the ability to go ahead and just make a new task, a new project, a new note very quickly, so you don't have to go digging through databases trying to find the button for that. But the three important sections that you see right at the top are your projects, your habits, as well as your tasks. Let's go ahead and talk about the projects first. The project section is basically anything that you have that would include a to-do list of things that you need to get done. This could be building a website if you're a freelancer, creating a product, launching your monthly newsletter, or even a fitness goal that you have for yourself. Really anything that has several tasks under it is what can be included in the projects. So let me show you an example of what one of them looks like. This is your project page template. As you can see, there's a database that populates that allows you to just start adding your to-do list for that project. You can include the date that it's due by, the priority, as well as the effort level. And then of course, inside every page, you can include any details that are necessary. Below that, you can find a quick overview of your project, the goals that you want to accomplish, any resources that you need in order to get it done, as well as any blockers that are keeping you from starting. So once you create a new task, what you can do is you can organize them in this section below. So right here, you can see that I already have a filter set up that shows me everything that I need to do today. If I want to see what's coming up this week, I can go ahead and click this filter option. I can sort everything by effort level or priority. I can see what is past due, what is complete, etc., etc. And then on the top right, I also have the ability to track my daily habits. This is nice because I'm trying to track habits every single day, like going to the gym, drinking enough water, journaling, meditating, stuff like that. But you can customize this however you want and just check off the boxes every day and you'll see your progress bar fill up. Now, if you want to automate this little database so that it refreshes your checklist every single day automatically, I do have a video for that that you can check out in the description. Moving on, you can see that we also have a task calendar. This makes it really easy. Just get a bird's eye view of what you have coming up as well as anything else that needs to get done. Pretty self-explanatory, but moving down to spaces. Now, this is an area that I really like because it allows me to actually organize my work. So instead of having a long list of projects that really aren't assigned to anything and I have to try and filter out some other way, I can organize those projects according to the space that it's associated with. So if I click on one of these, you'll see that it automatically opens a page that shows all of my projects for that specific space, as well as the tasks and any notes that are related to that as well. And then below that, I've also included a section that allows you to jot down any notes that you have for yourself. Now, these could be notes of things that you want to continue to work on. It could be you saving an article that you found or a video that you found useful. But on top of that, you can also associate your notes with certain projects. So let's say, for example, that I'm launching this product, which is the productivity kit. But I don't want to write down a launch strategy in the notes for that project. I want to keep it a little bit more general so it's stored in a different section and maybe I can associate it with other projects in the future. This allows me to keep everything separate and a little bit more organized. And then of course, something that I include in just about all my templates is a pin notes area. So you can go ahead and do that just by opening the note and clicking pin. But let's go ahead and dive into some of these other sections that you see at the top. One of my favorite parts of this template is probably the most simple area of it, and that is focus mode. This page is really meant for you to use every single day so that you can focus on just what you have to do that day. I've also included a timer at the top that allows you to time box yourself. I like to use this every single day so I can take little mental breaks here and there, separate myself from my work, and then come back and get the rest done. So let's say that you're at the end of your week, you feel like you've got a lot done, and you just want to make sure that you've checked off everything that you need to. That is where the weekly reports section comes in. This is something that I created so that whenever you hit this new button, you can generate a brand new report that will show you everything that you need to know for that past week. So when we open it, you can see a few things. You can see what you've completed for the past week, any tasks that are overdue that you need to reassign to a different day, as well as just some general reflection, like asking yourself what went well this week, what can you do better, as well as what are the goals for next week. So generally what I do is every single Friday, I generate one of these reports and I make sure that I've got everything done that I need to. If I missed anything, this template is going to let me know so that I can make sure that I don't miss it in the future. Now, aside from that, I have built out different sections for your projects, for example, so that you can get different views of what you have coming up, anything that's completed, as well as the progress that you've made. There is also a notes section that offers a few different ways to organize everything so you can find what you're looking for. And there's also the archive where you can find anything that you've completed and just want to get out of your databases. But in case you want to revisit that information in the future, it's not deleted, it's still available to you. And the last thing that I'll note here is I have created a mobile view for the productivity kit as well. So as a lot of you know, the Notion mobile app is, you know, it's got some work to do, but there are things that creators like myself can do in order to make the experience better for you. So what I would recommend is if you use Notion on your phone, when you download this template, go over to the mobile view and add it as a widget to your home screen so that you can access it very easily. And that's just about it. This is how I get things done every day. Like I said, if you want to check out the template, it is the first link in the description and it will include everything that you see here as well as instructions in the different areas so that you know how to use everything. Appreciate you checking out the video. And as always, if you have any Notion templates that you want to see me cover or even Notion tips that you want to see me go over, just let me know. I'm more than happy to do so. And until next time, I'll see you next time.